Greetings, students. Welcome back to my class. Students, how are you all? I hope that you all are fit and fine, and I hope the same for your family members. Students, I hope that you all are happy that your online classes have started again from today onwards, and I hope that you all were excited to attend the classes again. Students, before we go ahead with our syllabus, I want to ask few questions from you. The first question which I want to ask from all of you is that how were your midterm exams? I hope that you all have performed really well in your midterm exams, and I also hope that your performance will also be very good in your midterm exams result. And the result, I hope that you may get your result within 4-5 days or maybe next week, and I hope that you all will shine in your midterm exams result. Whatever it will be, your result will be very good. Students, although you have attempted the paper well, I teach you English, so we will discuss in today's class. We will discuss about the question paper. Although you have attempted the paper well, but there are few mistakes which everybody has done. If not, I would not say all of you have done, but many students have committed some mistakes. Because of them, their marks have been cut. And some mistakes, you don't expect it from the 10th class students. The mistakes which you people have done, not everybody has done, but some of you have done, and because of those mistakes which you committed in your midterm exams question paper of English, and that is why your marks have been cut. Now students, let's start with the writing section first. After telling you, we did formal letters. I told you in detail what is formal letter, how do we write formal letter, what is the format, how would you write the format. Still, although I have told many times, yet many students have done silly mistakes. I would not call them huge mistakes, but they were very silly mistakes. Because of those mistakes, your marks have been cut. Half marks or maybe one marks have been cut. So first we talk about the formal letter. Formal letter, I have told you kai baar bataya bhi hai what is the sequence, how do we write, what will be the first thing. Still there are many boys, though the girls are also there yet, but their number of girls are less, but still some girls have done the same mistake. What is the formal letter format, students? I told you many times that sender's address will come, right? Those who have not done any mistakes, they have got full marks. So it is about those who have done mistakes. Sender's address, then I have told you that you have to leave one line gap. Many students, first of all, sender's address, they have not written it. They have not written sender's address. They have directly written date and then receiver's address, and then after date also they have not left any line. The line gap, I told you, these small mistakes, it will cost you the marks. Your marks will be deducted. So sender's address, you have to leave one line, then you have to write the date, then you have to leave another one line, then you have to write the receiver's address. I have told you all these things, the first three things, right? And the base, and the more, I would say, many students, yes, I am using this word many, because many of you have done the same mistakes. Many, I have told you that now we will write salutation first. That means sir, jo bhi aap, salutation means greetings, aap jo likhte ho sir or ma'am, we will write first. Then after leaving one line, we will write the subject, what used to come, and what many students have done here. We will leave one line, then here also we will leave one line. What many students have done, they have written subject first and they have written salutation after the subject. So in everybody's, those who have done these mistakes, though I have not done this, that salutation will come first in subject, what how they have written, they have written like this, subject, then salutation. So I have to do this, that subject will come here and salutation will come first. I have to do this in there when I was checking the papers. So this was the mistake they have done. I have told you that salutation will come here, then subject will come afterward. How can you miss whether the sender's address is given or not in the formal letter? You have to write some, you know, if it is not given, you have to write from your own side, then you have to leave one line, then you have to write date, then leave another line, then you have to write receiver's address. We have been doing this for 3-4 years. I have been telling this to you for the last 3-4 years. Still you are committing this, you know, same mistake, and that is very annoying. And students, I am really not happy with the students, those who have committed this mistake. They have not written salutation after the receiver address, which is the correct thing, then after subject, then you have to divide, right? I have told you that you have to divide your formal letter in 2 to 3 small paragraphs. In first paragraph will be an introductory paragraph, you know, body of the letter which we say, or the content. You have to divide into, if you can't write in 3 paragraphs, just write 2 paragraphs, or at least write 2 small paragraphs, divide in 2 parts. First part may introductory part ho sakta body, introduction do aap, what is the letter is all about, with reference to context, or, you know, this is to whatever you want to write, introduction. Suppose it is a complaint, you can write that through the esteemed column of a newspaper, I want to draw the attention of the concerned authorities. Introduction though, about this problem, whatever the problem, then you can write about the problem in detail. Then the third paragraph you can write that we have complained many times and still there is no action taken yet, and they were all our complaints were in vain. So I hope that you will, you know, give some space, or you will publish this article in your newspaper so that the concerned authorities will be awakened. Like this, middle portion, then the conclusion. And then yours, many students still write, you write yours after thanking you. If you don't write thanking you, that is fine. If you don't write thanking you, fine. If you write, if आपने लिखा तो ठीक है, नहीं लिखा तो ठीक है, लेकिन आपको जब आप complimentary close दे रहे हो तो thanking you, yours truly, अब yours में भी mistake हैं. अब some student write yours like this, which is wrong. Some students have only written your. Some students are writing like this. Yours truly, simple, yours truly, faithfully. I have told you many times this, but nobody, like not nobody, most of you have written correctly, but many have done this mistake. So these were the silly mistakes. Because of these silly mistakes, I had to cut marks. मुझे काटने पड़े और I have cut. So that is what I am saying, students. And then you have to, now this was about the formal letter, students, and now we will talk about the next writing section, which was analytical paragraph, and which irritated me when I was checking, and when the students, you know, I would not take anybody's name, though I know the names very well from each section. In analytical paragraph, students, I was very disappointed when I was checking this analytical paragraph. I told you that analytical paragraph is a paragraph which is introduced this year, and in this there will be a chart, data, or chart or graph or table will be given, and according to that table or chart or pie chart or sakta graph or sakta, you have to analyze that, and then you have to write one paragraph, right? I told you, you will divide in 3 parts. First part will be introduction. First part will be introduction, second part will be its body. You can divide in 2 to 3 small paragraphs, small paras. Then conclusion. and I am not happy, and to tell you that very few you can count on fingers, some good students, they have written, they have followed this, what I told them, what is analytical paragraph. But on the other hand, there are some good students which have not followed this. They have made blunders, what blunder they have committed, they have done, I will tell you. First of all, they have written this analytical paragraph as a simple paragraph, they have written like a small previous paragraphs, like where there is a topic given, road accident, and they have written like this, road accidents, and then they have written one whole paragraph, and they were hoping, they were expecting that sir will give four and a half. I have not given, I have just written wrong manner or wrong pattern, and I have given three. It doesn't matter how good paragraph have you written, my dear students, if the pattern which is supposed to be followed, if you have not followed that pattern, marks will be cut. And I told you what is the pattern of analytical paragraph which you did not follow. Not everybody, but those who did not follow, I have written wrong pattern, and I have given 3 or maximum 3.5 marks, which I shouldn't have given, but I have given 3 at least. This was the those who have written in just like a normal paragraph, right? And a blunder. Boys are there, and I think there are few girls. I'm using few means very little, numbers are very less, but there are girls also, those who have made this blunder in analytical paragraph. I think the reason behind, you were not attending the online classes regularly on regular basis, and that's why, or if you were attending, then you were not sincere, you did not pay attention. So what blunder they have made? How can a 10th class student, I was just thinking that how can a 10th class student made this blunder? What they have written in analytical paragraph, many students have written sender's address, then they have written date of sender, any sender's address they have written, then they have written date 23rd September 2020, line gap, they have left line gap also to impress, then again after the date they have left the line, then they have written receiver's address. It was amazing to see. I was just speechless. I thought, what the hell they have done here, what were they thinking when they were writing receiver's address, then they have written subject, and then they have written salutation means sir, subject they have written increasing road accidents, then they have written salutation, in salutation they have written sir, then they have written it is quite disturbing to see about the increasing number of road accident, then the table they have mentioned 5, 6, or 7, 8 lines of the table given, which is, and they, but how can you write a letter, formal letter paragraph in an analytical paragraph? This is just not acceptable, my dear students. And where, and at end, after writing the body, like they were writing the formal letter format, then they have written body, then they have written thanking you yours faithfully or yours truly, this. So whomsoever have done this, I have simply circled it, then put a cross mark here also, thanking you, yours truly here also. And then I have mentioned that this is wrong way or wrong pattern, I have mentioned. And after that, for the content which they have written, I have given 2.5 or maximum 3 marks. That's it. Not more than that. Those who have done this blunder. I am just speechless, my dear students. And like, okay, I believe that every student is not the same level, you know. Everybody will not score 49, 48, 48 and half. But I was hoping that at least this I was not hoping. I am very disappointed. Those who have done this mistake. How could you do this, my dear student? How could you write, you know, a formal letter paragraph in an analytical formal letter sequence or formal letter format, formal letters format in an analytical paragraph? I told you that you have to write introduction, then you have to divide body into three small paragraphs, then conclusion you have to give, and I hope that it is easy to understand. But though you people have followed, you know, the format of formal letter in analytical paragraph, this is not acceptable, really not acceptable. And I was very, very disappointed with that, my dear students. So I hope I have told you, that is why I thought that I would continue with the syllabus, but then it was important, it was really necessary to discuss the paper, the major mistakes which you have done, the silly mistakes which you have. This was the major blunder. It cost the students 2.5 mark directly. If some other, you know, like maybe I have given 2.5 marks, I shouldn't have given. I gave 2.5 marks. Yeah, I have given. I shouldn't have given, but I have given. I don't know what would happen in board if you will do like the major blunder, the blunder like this if you will make in the board. I don't know what is going to happen. Your result is going to suffer. That's why I did not want to go ahead with the syllabus without discussing the question paper, without discussing these major and minor mistakes which you have done, blunder you have done, and mistakes, silly mistakes you have also done. Like subject will come after the salutation, you have written before the salutation, then subject is coming, then salutation. That is wrong, right? And in formal letter, if sales manager you are writing, who will write the? Many of you have not written the before the sales manager. It will come the sales manager, sales, the sales manager. Few students, the same silly mistakes, they have written M small, some have written M capital, so they have written S small. That is not acceptable from a 10th class students. My dear student, from a 10th class student, it is not acceptable. So please take care of these mistakes and don't repeat this kind of blunder, which you people, not everybody, but some of you have done. So please don't repeat these blunders and these silly mistakes in your upcoming exams. I hope you will follow my advice. Please do that. Now we will discuss about the grammar portion, my dear students. Grammar portion, we will discuss with the rearrange. If you want to rearrange, the most, I would say 95% students rearrange were correct. Hardly there were 5% students whose one or two rearrange were wrong. So let's not discuss it. We will discuss about the error. So the error portion, the question was, read these four part as the whole sentence and find out that in which portion, I mean which part, A, B, C, D, in which part the error is there. You just have to mention the A part, but many of you corrected it. That is also fine. Those who have mentioned that the first question of error part, there was error in the A part, A, B, C, D, both the questions, first question of error was divided in four part, though the error was in A part, and the errors was, it was given have, it will be has. And the second, polluting. Second mein tha polluting, which was the C portion, and the answer will be polluted. Many are saying the da or a aana chahiye, but if you have written this, this is not the answer. The answer is polluted. There is one error, so that is why the error will be polluted. Those have written, some of you have mentioned both, pollute a द की जगह ये लिखा है. तो आई हैव गिवन मार्क्स फॉर दिस एंड दिस. इफ यू हैव डन दिस यू विल गेट फुल मार्क्स इन द 2 out of 2. नाउ ओमिशन, इफ यू टॉक अबाउट ओमिशन, सो ओमिशन देर वॉज स्टिल द सेम क्वेश्चन. दे आर रीड दोज 4 parts एज 1 whole sentence एंड फाइंड द मिस्टेक्स विच पार्ट इज हैविंग द ओमिटेड वर्ड. सो MCQs were there, 4 options were there. It was easy for you, many of you, almost everybody, not everyone, but almost 95% students have done the correct answer, given the correct answer. So, omission, the first question jo tha, uska answer tha A part mein, and that was missing word was how, and the second, the second question also answer was A, the, how and the. If you have done these two, you will get 2 out of 2 in this also. Otherwise, marks would have cut. Cut hi diye honge maine. Now, students, we talk about gap filling. It was very easy, but still many, not many. There are number of students who have committed mistakes. The gap filling answer, I am telling you. Gap filling, the first answer is found, second is used, third is said. So this, if you have done these three, if you have written these three, you would have get full marks for 3 out of 3 of this. Now we will discuss about the RTC, and RTC question number was 8 and 9. So 8, there were 2 parts, like you have to do one, you know, one or do this or do this, then in 9th also do this or this also. So part 1, the 8th question hai, part 1 answers I am writing. Who is the author, the first part, jo first flight ka tha, to uska answer hoga first Liam O. Flaherty, author name. Then the under his wing, what was father doing? Father was, you know, preening the feathers, feathers on his white back. Father was doing this, right? And who was looking at the seagull? His mother. This is the answer. These are the 4 answers of 8th question RDC first part 1. इसी में जो option में दिया हुआ था उसके answers I am also writing the answers of that or one. जो दिया हुआ था that the answer will be, the first is Nelson Mandela, the author of this chapter Nelson Rohila Mandela, the full answer is given. Second is, you know, the dark skinned people were there, and international guest, you know, distinguished international guest jo aa rakhe the, you can write international guests. Fourth question was all of them. It was a victory for peace, joy, everything. So the D portion, all of them. This was the answer. These are the answers of 1, 2, 3, 4, you know, if you have done the OR portion. Now question number 9, which is the second RTC. So isme jo part 1 tha, uske jo answers hain, the answers of the part 1 is, first is tiger, second he was angry, means here also many students have written wrong answer. They have written something else, happy, lazy, I don't know what. And third answer will be encased. This also number of students have given wrong answer for this and this. So marks have been cut. And the fourth, the author, poet name is Leslie Norris. The poet name there was, what is the name of the poet of this chapter, of this poem? So Leslie Norris. Now or part, जो the RTC में 2 parts दिए थे, question number 8 में 2 parts थे, इसमें भी 2 parts थे और करके, तो उसका जो answer है, the first answer is boy was sad, second the harbor. Here also few students have written the wrong answer, so their marks have been cut. Second answer was the harbor, and third answer, he has lost the ball forever. He has lost the ball forever. उसकी बॉल हमेशा के लिए घूम गई है, ठीक है. नाउ फोर्थ आंसर, द पोइट नेम इज़ जॉन बैरीमैन. जॉन बैरीमैन. सो आई होप स्टूडेंट्स दीज आर द आंसर यू हैव डन दिस. एंड स्टूडेंट्स इन द दिस दीज वर द थिंग्स विच आई वॉन्टेड टू डिस्कस, you know, about, especially about the writing section, about letter and about the, you know, analytical paragraph. And I wanted to discuss about grammar portion. I wanted to tell you the answers of the RTCs also. And we have discussed this question paper. So students, I hope that whatever doubts you were having, it will be clear. And in the next class, of course, we will continue with the syllabus. So I hope there is no doubt now. So in this class, that is it for today. We will meet tomorrow again, and we will, you know, continue with the syllabus. Thank you.